It's my pleasure to introduce two pioneers who have been really a staple part of the freedom community over the last 3 to 4 years. Hands up who's been to the Hope Sussex community, who's heard of the Hope Sussex. Wow, so we're going to hear all about the origin story about Hope Sussex came into reality, creating our own beautiful reality through community, through like-minded, free, loving souls. They have a passion for education and helping people to find a sense of curiosity and exploration so that we can enhance ourselves, how we can impact the next generation. So please give a warm welcome to Sadie Single and Katy-Jo Murphin.
Thank you. Thank you, Dan. Thank you. Oh, hello. Hello, everybody. This is Sadie.
Hello.
And I am Katy-Jo, and we are the founders and directors of Hope Sussex Community, CIC. We normally speak from the heart and don't use any notes or anything, but because we are restricted with time, we have written down what we're going to speak to you today, so we don't miss anything, we don't and ah, and don't go off on tangents, which is what we normally do.
We do, yeah. Before
we start, though, I would like to say that hope as it is today was something we never envisaged. We never saw exactly what hope was going to be. We just knew that we needed to make something happen. I was compelled to build community in 2019. And I met this amazing lady, and this is why we are here now. Along with all the other incredible volunteers and community members, Hope has grown organically into what it is today. And really excited to share our story with you. So I'll hand you over to Sadie.
Thank you. Are we able to put on the PowerPoint at all? Thank you. So, Dan asked, who here has been to Hope? I didn't really quite catch it, so put your hands up if you actually have been to Hope. Okay, that is not good enough. Put your hands up if you've not been to Hope. Oh my gosh! Where have you been? We've had it all going on. Right, you've got to change that, okay? At some point before the year's out, or at some point next year, you've got to come to Hope. You have to. We are an autonomous community. We have been born out of the chaos of this great reset agenda. Our wider community sits at around 1,700 people, but we have a very core community who regularly come to Hope of around 150 people. We were born from a dream to create a space for like-minded adults and children to come together to educate, to socialise, to grow food and empower themselves. We have done this, and we are one of the greatest success stories to have grown from this fantastic movement that we are all part of towards a better world. So Hope is near Battle, East Sussex. We have a beautiful site that houses around 6 buildings that range from our treehouse, which is a larger drama dance studio, a large barn that is used as a workshop space for practical skills and other teaching classes. Our living classroom building, which has a grass roof and holds 4 classrooms and an office space. We have a wooden cabin in the garden called the Hangout, which has got a range of musical instruments for the children to go and do musical classes or just go and enjoy time in there. We have a building that we call the Beehive, which has treatment rooms that we have people come and rent from us and put different holistic treatments on. And we have our beautiful hub, which is where we come together as a community with our community kitchen. We have the use of 2 large fields and the woodland that reside next to us. And we operate basically like a community centre. We're open regularly Monday to Wednesday for home education sessions, but we are also there for our wider community to come and join us during the week for lunches, for gardening, for health treatments, and also just to really just come and be at Hope. We run a massive variety of events that basically keep us funded. But the real success of Hope is that we have remained very true to our core ethos, that we strongly believe that we are ruled by deeply corrupt career politicians who are out purely for themselves. And Hope is the exact opposite to this. We are built purely on love, trust, respect, and liberty. Over to Katy-Jo.
Lovely. Thanks, Sadie. So, hope ultimately provides a home for like-minded, freedom-loving souls to build community and the reality they want. Hope provides a place where we can offer one another support and live a life of purpose. We provide a venue for home educating families to access a plethora of subjects delivered by independent tutors who hire the space from Hope for their sessions. It was the need for an awake home ed community that started this project off, but Hope offers support to many different people. We have members of all ages that come to spend time with their tribe. Some come weekly, some come monthly, some come just for events, and some come from as far as Scotland as often as they can. It's an incredible project to be a part of and restores my faith in humanity daily. So we have four branches to Hope. It's the best way to describe Hope is with the Hope Tree. There are four branches, and with these four branches, we are providing nearly everything a community needs to thrive. The sharing of knowledge and education is vital for a community to be self-sufficient and autonomous. This happens in many ways at Hope, through workshops, sessions, talks, and in practical ways by getting your hands dirty in the allotment and getting involved in work weekends. We are non-residential, with no plans at the moment to change that, and we firmly believe that this is the reason that we have made it to our fourth year. So let's have a look at the four branches of Hope. Health. Our own health is something we must take responsibility for. And at Hope, we have a dedicated space for treatments called the Beehive. During the week, we have therapists offering low-cost treatments in a wide range of modalities, like bioresonance frequency, crystal therapy, Reiki, Scanar, and many more. We have a monthly low-cost PHA clinic, offering homeopathy, reflexology, massage and more, and we have regular workshops and talks on health. Being in optimum health in all areas, emotionally, physically, mentally and spiritually, means everything if we are going to have the energy to build the new earth.
And ultimately, health begins with great food. So we know that much of the food that we go out and buy in supermarkets is in actual fact poisoning us. We all have a responsibility to educate ourselves on how to provide food for our families, being self-sufficient, resilient, and not reliant on large corporations to provide it for us. This new world that we're building is about taking an active role in making that happen. And this means that we shouldn't just be providing food for people, but educating them in how to grow it and to create it for themselves. At Hope, we're teaching children and adults where food comes from, how to grow it, using no-dig methods, and we have multiple polytunnels to produce beautiful organic food grown with love. And we use this to sell organic veg boxes, but also we use it in our community cooking and also in our cookery classes. So if you get to come to Hope, you will get to experience the amazing food that is grown there.
So events and community is the third branch, and at Hope we work incredibly hard, but there must always be time for fun and celebration. Who had a good time last night? Woo! The entertainment last night was amazing, and we were dancing our socks off. It was absolutely brilliant. And it's just as important. Sharing good times and making memories strengthens a community and raises the vibration, which is so desperately needed. It was always a dream to hold a music festival at Hope. And at the end of our first year, in 2022, we held the first Freedom Music Festival. We wanted to give those artists that had kept their integrity and not acquiesced in order to keep their careers, to share a stage to share the truth, their talents with an audience that appreciates them for the courageous beings that they are. The Freedom Music Festival this year was our third and best yet, with hugely talented artists in the Freedom Movement giving phenomenal performances. Soom T, Danny Rampling, Slipmat, Victorious Daz Band, the list goes on, and they are all coming back again next year, which will be our fourth year, so don't miss it, get your tickets. the fantastic Karen Dodd. Who's heard of Karen Dodd and the Freedom Network? Another amazing, amazing project. They have brought the wonderful Uprise and Shine events to Hope 5 times. We also have amazing people at Hope like Matt Letizier and Kate Shimarani deliver inspiring talks, and Katie Hopkins has brought her tour to Hope 2x. It's these larger events that bring enough money in to the project to keep it going. But we also hold smaller, regular events throughout the year, like Christmas markets, summer fates, comedy nights, empowering workshops, Camp Hope, a week where families can come and camp and experience the home ed community at Hope for a whole week. The list goes on, and we have practically something on every weekend.
Okay. The reason why we're here, really, education. My background is a primary school teacher. I was there for my sins for 11 years up until COVID. And honestly, the best thing that happened to me was to remove my children from the state education system. I met Katy-Jo, and that's where Hope was born. But let's be honest, schools are not fit for purpose. And it is ultimately a state indoctrination system. The Education Act in 1880 made school compulsory for children aged 5 to 10 years. That was 144 years ago, and in reality, not much has changed at all. And if you look at any other parts of society, huge, great changes have taken place within it, but not in the education system. They're pretty much exactly the same. A classroom now doesn't look much different to a classroom 144 years ago. However, cultural Marxists have taken over, and schools are now places that we hear constant horror stories from. We hear it on a weekly basis, families contacting us saying their children are
suffering
terribly, with mental health issues, with bullying, with all sorts of issues.
Bullying from teachers as well.
Absolutely, yeah. The woke agenda is rife, and schools are not safeguarding children as they are meant to. Children are being sexualized at a disgustingly early age, and our belief is that home education is the best place for children. At Hope, we highly value education, and this was the reason for Hope's existence in the first place. Educational responsibility, I believe, should reside with parents, the people who know their children the best. And just because we were all educated by a state education system does not mean that it is right for our own children. You probably know better than your parents, which is why you're all here now, okay? You're sitting in this room, okay? If you're sitting next to your parent, then they've probably done a very good job because you're here now. So well done, those parents, that's brilliant. Now, you don't need to be an educator to educate your children in homeschooling. But you do need to be an educational facilitator. And it can be very isolating being in home education.
I experienced that with my eldest. Mm. My eldest, who's 20 now, when I took her out, when she was 11, halfway through secondary school, first year of secondary school, I just realised that it wasn't right for her, and her beautiful, shining, bright light was diminishing day by day, and I just took her out. I didn't know anything about home education. I just knew it was something I had to do. But I didn't click with any of the communities in my area. And so when COVID kicked off, that was it. I was making it a mission that I wasn't going to be isolated with my other two children.
Absolutely. So because it can be isolating, you need community around you. We need a support network of a wider community, a nurturing community of peers of all ages and other adults. It's so massively important in a home education journey. And at Hope, we have these brilliant independent tutors that rent our rooms and provide the most incredible sessions from ages from babies all the way through to adults. And there is a natural focus at Hope on practical skills, life skills, and creative subjects like drama, dance, music, and art, as well as more academic subjects like maths, science, history, and English, and also trivium. Not all children want to go down the GCSE route, and that is one of the many benefits of home educating, because schools don't offer that they force all children into the GCSE route. Some children who are home educated do want to go down the GCSE route, and at Hope we facilitate that as well. And many of Hope's teens have gone on to college this year, and we've had our first cohort of GCSE students this summer go through, took exams in sociology, English and maths, and we can proudly say, although I'm not, you know, I don't uphold and rate their system, and I would love to not have to have GCSEs, we have got 100% GCSE pass rate at Hope, which is fantastic.
It's, whilst we're on GCSEs, I just want to give my second, use an example for you, how you don't have to do the conventional route. So my second daughter, Poppy May, left Hope at 15 and went to college a year early. Because she is home educated, she was able to go at 15. She went to college with one GCSE, and she did an SQA that year. She's now at 16 in the second year of a degree course with one GCSE. So making our children, forcing them to do 9 GCSEs and the pressure that they are under to gain results. Who here uses their GCSEs? Whoever tells anybody, who's ever asked what you got for your GCSEs? You never are. So it's really important that we aren't so fixated on this one size fits all, because our children deserve better. Yeah. Sorry, just had to add that in there. So, am I on How Hope Works?
Yeah.
Okay, lovely.
Katy-Jo, tell us.
The number one reason Hope works is because it is run by selfless, generous, kind-hearted souls that volunteer an immense amount of time and energy into the project, and they do it all for free. And I know a lot of them will be watching, so we love them all to absolute bits. One of them sat right there.
She is.
There she is, lovely AB. So, we all know that it's down to us to create our own reality and the world we want to live in, and we can't rely on anyone else to do it for us. We are set up as a CIC, a community interest company, which means we can receive donations, raise funds through events, and ask for discounts and freebies from companies, as we are not for profit. We started this project without a penny and have managed to make it to our fourth year without any government funding or council funding. We survive. Oh, thank you.
Thank you.
We survive by running events, fundraising, and on kind-hearted donations. Our beautiful site, although we don't own it, feels like home. And we are incredibly lucky to have a very supportive landlord who's got our backs.
Right, so everybody needs community. Many communities have sprung up since COVID, and it truly was a great blessing for us all, wasn't it? Yeah. Come on, people. Yes, it was, absolutely.
You wouldn't be here now without it.
No, absolutely not. Many of those communities do exist purely online, which has worked for many people and has brought many people together. But remember, online communities can be turned off with a flick of a switch or the pull of a plug. And they know that the worst thing that they can do for human beings is to put us in isolation. It makes us sick, it makes us weak, and it takes away our basic humanity. We were never, ever, ever meant to be isolated. And thank you. And it was a terrible thing for children through all of that era, was that children suffered the greatest out of everyone. But we are not also meant to raise children on our own. We are always meant to be part of community. It is how it's always been done. And the old saying, it takes a village to raise a child, is very true. As humans, we need tangibility. For a real community to flourish, we need space that we can build and we can grow as a community. Hope are very lucky that we have communities across the whole of the UK. They're not just people who live within our vicinity who can come to us regularly. We have members all over the place. And the biggest thing that hope has and that people bring to hope is the energy. Mm. And it's the one thing that people really notice when they come to hope. Yeah. It is so incredibly powerful. The vibrational energy is massively raised every time we have an event at Hope and we bring people together. It literally blows people away. And people don't even have to be at Hope. They feel it as they're coming towards Hope. And it has reduced many people to tears. We even had a wedding this summer, which was just amazing. We had a wedding at our music festival. The beautiful Jess and Davey, we were so very honoured and privileged that they chose to be married at Hope. They couldn't think of anywhere else they wanted to be married other than surrounded by all of their beautiful friends and family. And it was truly, truly beautiful. But ultimately, it is all about living a life of purpose and giving for others. So on that note, I'm going to pass you over.
Yeah, living a life of purpose. It's up to us to give meaning and purpose to life. And it is the absolute key to happiness. I can genuinely say that serving my community is my happy place. And I know I'm not alone. I hear from Hope community members all the time that contributing in some way, be it in the allotment, washing up in the kitchen, performing, cleaning loos, cooking, gives them soul nourishment that can only be achieved by giving to something bigger than yourself. It makes your heart full and makes life worthwhile. Giving without the expectation of receiving anything in return, or without having a personal agenda, is how we create the world we want. It is. A world without the low-vibing emotions, the powers that used to be, need to survive. A world full of love, hope, and gratitude.
Absolutely. It's about transcending fear, yeah? There is just no space for it. We have been attacked so many times by the mass media at Hope, sometimes on a weekly basis. I think there's literally some journalists who go to bed thinking about Hope, wake up thinking about a Hope. It's become a little bit silly. But it simply means nothing to us. They are an irrelevance, they're not important. And to be honest, it is a badge of honour. We are clearly doing something that the system do not like when they write about us so frequently. And another cliche, you only get flak when you're over the target. So there we go. Every single day that Hope is open and supporting our like-minded community is a massive two fingers to the system and to the state. And it is by its very nature a protest. We know that they don't like what we're doing because they wouldn't have their media hounds writing all this nonsense about us, calling us a school for conspiracy theorists or teaching far-right rhetoric and all the nonsense they say. The fact that Hope by its very name means to have an optimistic state of mind that is based on an expectation of positive outcomes with respect to events and circumstances in one's life or the world at large. I can't believe I've just quoted from Wikipedia. Unreal, but there we go. I Googled it, it must
be right.
At Hope, we want to create events and opportunities that help people to move beyond fear. By acknowledging that fear comes from a place of little or no knowledge, okay, about a subject. So empowering both adults and children with this knowledge is exactly what is needed. It is also about teaching life skills and resilience in children to be prepared for a future that none of us know what it's going to look like at all. So we have actually got a sponsored event going on in November for a winter camp out. And this is to hone survival and bushcraft skills, but also to test children's own resilience and strength to cope with a night outside where they've built their own shelter.
Yeah, that's Matt's idea.
Yeah, that's my husband.
He's going to put that out there.
He's a massive child.
It's a bit crazy, that idea.
I'm sponsoring you to do it, because I know how cold you get. We're going to raise loads of money. The money that we raise is going to go to fund more equipment to the children at Hope. But we will not let them feed on our fear, especially when we had the police arrive at our very first music festival, so arrogantly assuming that we were going to let them on,
yes, come on
to the very first Hope Music Festival so that they could walk around and check our licenses. We had a line of people stood at the gate to stop them coming in, and they couldn't believe that we had the audacity to not let them on. But we were like, no, you're not coming on.
We don't
absolutely
need your help.
Not.
This is incredibly peaceful.
Yeah,
we
absolutely
definitely don't need your help. But we will call you if we do. Thank you.
And we had two Jobsworths walking down the lane with body cams on and clipboards to announce that they were from...
running an unregistered school.
It was a bit like that. We're from Her Majesty's Unregistered Schools team, and we believe you're running an illegal
We've seen
school.
Children being dropped off.
Yes. So they clearly haven't, because we don't have a drop-off.
No, it's not drop-off. No. It's not drop-off.
So, anyway, they were not allowed on site. They were stopped at the gate and told to leave immediately. And we have since emailed Ofsted to check if we are under any kind of investigation, and we're not. Despite what the media like to report that we are, we're absolutely not under any investigation. They know that we're not running an illegal school at all. So we don't feed into their fear. We all simply transcend beyond it. Thank you.
Beautiful. Beautiful.
Right, the world needs more hope.
It does. The world needs more hope. Our definition of hope, not a false hope. It isn't sitting there and hoping someone else is going to come and save you. There are no saviours in this world. That's been a huge part of the programming we've all been subjected to. Instead, our hope is a positive one. An optimistic and proactive one, approaching life in a goal, in a goal-oriented way, being creative and finding different ways to bring this beautiful new reality into fruition, believing that you can instigate change and you can achieve anything. You have to be the change you want to see. You have to create the reality you want. Stop spending time watching all the fear porn, including the worrying about all the negativity and devastation in the world. Instead, spend your time walking the walk and talking the talk. I'm not saying it's easy. I'm not saying it's not exhausting. I'm not saying there won't be sacrifices, but you will be so glad you did. And anyway, there really isn't any other option. It is down to us. So building community and a better world for our children and the future generations must be everyone's top priority. We have given advice to other startup communities before, but the best way to understand hope and how it works is to come and visit us.
Absolutely. So why is supporting hope important? Why are we even standing here today talking to you, you know, about this project that we've created? Well, we are immensely grateful to Dan and Derek for giving us this opportunity to come and speak here this weekend and to share what we have built. And it has been really, really beautiful to come and connect again with so many brilliant souls. People here who we've met previously, new people we've met, people who are wanting to make a real difference. And that is you guys, so well done. However, the reality is that we absolutely must do more than sitting in a corporate conference room. In fact, I'd go as far to say it is our duty and our responsibility to do more. It has cost us travel money, time away from the millions of hope tasks that we've still got to do, and our families to get here this weekend. So I implore you to please make it worth our time, because whilst we are here to encourage you to build community in your areas, we are also need you to support our growing community at Hope. Like Neil said yesterday, it is the children who absolutely should be our focus. We simply have to create strong communities for all of the children. They deserve so much better than mainstream society. A mainstream society that is toxic for children. It wants children lazy, uncreative, addicts to gaming and sugar, sexualized, robbing them of their childhoods through a woke agenda, being drip-fed adverts for branded goods that they can't afford, depressed and in debt, dreamless and isolated. So by investing in community, we allow children to be children. And it is these home-educated children that think outside of the box, that can be critical thinkers, to be creative, to be problem solvers, that will make the great changes that are needed. These are the children who ultimately are worth investing in. And this is why all of our beautiful, beautiful Hope volunteers give all that they do for free and so willingly. Hope has proven that the model we have built for a community CIC works. We have proven that this can be done, but we do need more support. We need some more support financially. We need people to come and collaborate with us to put on events like this. We need people to come to our events, support our festival, join up as members, follow us on social media, share our events. We are in our fourth year. We are here. We are definitely not going away, but we do need your support because we are the success story. Thank you.
Okay. We can have our advert.
Hope Sussex community has witnessed firsthand the positive effect community home education can have on children and their families, and it is wondrous. Our mission is to support, enhance and guide freedom-loving families through the empowering and rewarding world of home education. Sessions with tutors start at the incredibly affordable price of just £5.50 an hour and run all day Monday to Wednesday. The groups are small, and as home educators, you can book directly with our independent tutors, attending as many sessions as you like out of the wide range of subjects on offer. As we now begin the fourth year of our journey, our legacy is already taking shape, with children that have previously attended Hope now flourishing at college, as critically thinking, compassionate, creative, confident, and resilient young adults. At Hope, we are incredibly proud of what we have achieved, and extremely excited to be creating the reality we want. A life and world full of love, truth, integrity, and freedom.
Thank you so much for listening.
Thank you. Thank you.
Make some noise for these lovely ladies, everybody.
Aww, thank you.
Great job.